Good morning, everyone, and you're very welcome back to Age and Opportunities Movement Minutes with myself, Paul. Hope you're all well this Monday morning, that you've enjoyed your weekend and you're ready to join us for this morning's seated session. And for that seated session, if this is new to you, you're very welcome, first of all. And secondly, what you're going to need is just yourself, a good sturdy chair, preferably with no arms. And this morning we're going to need some light weights. Okay, so you mightn't have the actual weights about the house, but what you may have is tins of fruit, tins of soup maybe, or bottles of water. So just anything at all, just to give you an extra bit of weight for some of our movements. And if you don't have it to hand at this moment, don't worry, you can do the movements with us. And then at a later date, maybe, or a later time, when you have the weights, you can watch this video back, either here on Facebook or on YouTube, and you can do the movements or the exercises with the weights. So I'll just give you a bit of time to grab those if they're near at hand. And just in the meantime, I'm just going to say hello to Michael O'Neill up in the dock. Michael was straight off the bat this morning, and he's raring to go. Good to hear, Michael. And Jerry is there as well. Mary Kelly and Carvel over in Blanchardstown. So good morning to you all, folks. And anybody else tuning in this morning, just don't be afraid to say hello. You don't have to now, but you can just give us a hand or a thumbs up. And it's always great to hear where people are tuning in from as well. And Mary Cox is smiling through the April showers. There was plenty of April showers here yesterday as well, Mary. It was a cool one now. And I know there was maybe snow in other parts of the country, so we weren't that bad now. We got away, luckily enough. But I think it's given it to be a bit warmer for the rest of the week, Mary. So here's hoping. And again, anyone else, just drop us a wee comment or give us a thumbs up, anything at all, just to let us know you're tuning in. It's always good to hear from people. And if you happen to be watching this back afterwards, which I know a lot of people do, again, just pop us a comment. Let us know you've been here, or otherwise we'll just be passing ships in the night. So even if you're not watching it live, which is understandable, a lot of the time things happen and things come up, that if you're watching it back afterwards, just let us know. And I agree with Michael, it's great to be part of this community, Michael. We're all part of it. And we've been going now for over a year, hard to believe now, but we're still here and we're still moving. And on that note, I'll ask everybody now if you're ready. We're just going to take a seat just on our chair, and what I'll ask you to do is just walk your hips just towards the front of the chair. Okay. And we're going to sit up nice and tall, and we're going to roll the shoulders back for 3, 2, and 1. And then we're going to take both hands and just place them on our laps or on our thighs with our palms facing up towards the ceiling. And we're just going to close down the eyes. And then we're just going to begin by taking 3 deep breaths. So a nice breath in through the nose. Lift the chest up. Exhale, chest goes down. Begin to open the eyes once more, and we're just going to begin our warm up now. So just nice and easy, just marching on the spot. So just gently moving the feet. So we don't have the full foot on the floor. You can see here from the side view, my heel is lifted off the floor. Okay, so it's just the front part of the foot that's making contact. Just a nice light step, not too heavy. Okay, and from there then, we're just going to reach both hands out in front. So nice wide hands, spread out the fingers, and then just get the fingers moving. So just nice and easy, holding the hands out in front of the chest, moving the fingers, moving the thumbs. And we're going to reach over to the right hand side, do the same thing again. Slowly bring it back to center, and out to the left hand side, and back to center once more. Great stuff. From there then, we're just going to separate the hands. So we're going to reach one hand up, one hand down. Fingers and thumbs are still moving. Coming back to center, Reaching one hand up, one hand down. Fingers moving all the while. Back to centre then again. And we just bring the hands back. Bring the elbows back. And we push the arms forward. Okay. So just bringing the elbows back in line with the shoulders. Reaching out the front. Back in line with the shoulders. Reaching all the way out the front. For three. Two. And one, great stuff. Just bring the hands down then by the side. We're going to bend the arms at the elbows and bring the fingertips up to meet the front of the shoulders. So just nice and easy. Elbows tucked in nice and neatly by the side. And just bring the fingertips up to meet the front of the shoulders. So four, three, two. And last one, and slowly down. And then we bring the arms up at the side. We alternate, we bring them up at the front. Up at the side. And up at the front. So just nice and relaxed, nice and controlled. And last time now out to the side. And last time up to the front. Slowly back down. We're just going to plant the feet now, so just relax the feet. Just plant them nice firmly on the ground. Sitting up nice and tall once again. We're going to place our hands just on the outside of the front legs of the chair. And we're just going to dip down to the side. Back up to centre. Dip down to the opposite side and back up to centre. And once again we alternate then between the right and the left side. So just a nice reach down to the side of the chair. Tilting the body. And one more time now off the right side. And last time off the left. Back up the centre again. You just place the hands now just on top of the thighs. Point the toe on the ground and lifting the heel off the ground. And we're just going to lift out to the side. Slowly bring that foot back in again. So just reaching the toes out to the side. Slowly bringing it back in. So just working off the one foot to begin with. And then to the other foot. So again, lifting the heel off the ground, reaching out to the side, slowly bring it back in. Just a nice lift. And back in. And final one now. Slowly back in. And then our final movement this morning, just as part of our warm up for our lower body. We're going to grab the sides of the chair at the front, okay? Place both heels on the ground with our toes pointing up towards the ceiling. And then we bring our toes back, the toes touch the ground, okay? So heels on the ground, toes on the ground. We're trying to get the feet as close together as possible. So heels in front, toes behind, heels in front, toes behind. Great stuff. We're just going to finish now with the last three. Two. And final one. Just placing the feet firmly on the ground once more. And now if you have in the hand, I'll ask you just to grab your weights or whatever weight substitutes that you have this morning. So with our warm-up done, we're going to get into our weighted movements. And again, if you haven't got your weights to hand at the minute, that's okay. You can still do the movements and maybe revisit at a later time with your weights. Okay, so just starting off nice and easy, just with our hands down by our side and our palms facing away from each other. Okay, and just go back to that movement that we did in the warm-up. We're taking our hands up towards the front of our shoulders. Again, it's just important to tuck the elbows in at the side and slowly relax them back down. And as we bring the hands up, we breathe out. And as we bring them down, we breathe in. Last three. Two. And final one. Blowing out on the way up. Slowly back out on the way down. Hands then, and our palms facing in towards us and in towards the chair. We're going to lift the weights up at the side, or lift our hands up at the side and slowly come back down. So we're going no higher than our shoulder height. the hands and the knuckles are just going in a line, ideally, with the shoulders. If you can't get them up that high, that's okay. Just lift them up as high as you can. We'll just do three more of these. Last two. And final one. Great stuff. Slowly lower that back down. Just twist your hands now. Leave the arms at the same place. So twist the hands so that your palms are facing out behind you. So they're facing away from you. And then we're going to lift again as we did. So just lifting those arms up in line with the shoulders. Slowly back down. Great stuff. And again, go at your own pace. I'm just here to give you a lead. You don't have to do exactly everything that I do. If you need to take a break between any of the movements, you can as well, of course. And we're just going to go for three more. Last two. On the zipper ahead. And slowly back down. With our hands down over our sides, palms once again facing in towards our body. We're just going to dip down either side. Okay. So just like the warm up, the only difference is this time we're not holding the sides of the chair. Our arms are either free, or our hands are free, or we're holding our weights. So again, just reaching down to the side, take it back up, reach down to the other side, and then alternate between both. Last four, three, two, and last one, taking it back up, placing our weights then, just to give our hands a break, just placing them on our thighs, just to relax the fingers out. Okay, and then we'll ask you just to spread your legs nice and wide, so there's a nice gap between them. We're going to place our hands or our weights then, side by side, sitting up nice and tall once more. We lift them up just to come under our chin. Okay, so just imagine yourself, you have a big long coat. You're just zipping that coat. And if you're like Mary and you're out in the April showers, you want to zip it all the way up to the top. You don't want to get wet. So we're taking it up as high as we can. Elbows are pointing out to the side. Great stuff. And we're just going to go for four more. Last three. Two, and final one, slowly lower it back down. We're going to grab our weights now by the very, very edge if you can, okay, if it's manageable. And what we're going to do again, sit up nice and tall in the chair. We're going to lift those hands up in the air, okay, so reaching them up as high as we can, and then we bend the elbows. And we lower the weights just down towards the back of our shoulders. Just down, tipping the shoulders, and back up, slowly down, pushing all the way back up. And again, just do as many as you can. If you need to take a break at any stage, don't be afraid to. And we'll go for four more. Last three. Two. And final one, all the way up in the air, and slowly bring them back down once more. And then the last you to do that is just place your weights on the floor directly in front of your feet. Okay, so just place them down, either upright or on their side, whatever works best for you. And we're going to place both feet to one side of the weights. Okay, you can hold on to the chair, the front of the chair for this one if you need. And we're just going to start off nice and easy, just lifting the feet over and lifting them back. Okay, so the aim of the game, or the name of the game here, is to lift your feet over without punching your weights. Okay, so if you're lucky like me and they're small, that's relatively easy, but you might have bigger weights or more upright weights. It's going to make it a bit harder. So just lifting over nice and easy. Okay, you can continue on with that if you wish. I'm just going to give you another progression here. So just to make it maybe a little bit harder for yourself, or a little bit more challenging, we're going to lift both feet over at the same time. Okay, so as you can see, this one's going to be a bit more difficult. You're going to have to swivel your bum in the chair. You're going to have to grab onto the sides or the front of the chair as well, just for that extra bit of support. So just lifting over and lifting back. But if you're happy enough to go with the first one, you're just lifting over one leg at a time and lifting them back. So we're just going to go for four more now to finish. Three, two, and final one, and back to where we started. Great stuff. And you can just relax the feet out there. Once again, we're just going to take the weights in our hands, okay, and then sitting up nice and tall in the chair, we're going to hold those weights up in front, and we're going to look through our forearms, okay, so there should be a little gap between our forearms that we're able to look through. Our elbows are bent, and our upper arm is parallel with the floor, okay? And what we're going to do, we're just going to make that gap a bit wider. So bringing the hands and the arms out to the side, we narrow the gap, and we make the gap a bit wider, okay? So just lifting out to the side, slowly bring it back in, go out to the side, slowly bring it back in. Great stuff. And we're just going to go now just to finish off the last five, four, three, two, and final one. Great stuff. And again, just give the hands a little shake out there if you need. And sitting up nice and tall once more on the chair, we're going to hold our weights now just in front of our chest. And we're just going to reach across one hand at a time. So just extending out the arm just for a nice little box or a little jab. Just across the body. You can twist the trunk as well to reach across. So just extending out the left arm to the right hand side and the right hand to the left hand side. And then you go at your own pace. Okay, so again, this pace is just to gauge it. You can go slower, or you can go faster if you wish. So just reaching across the body. And then we'll see if we can go a little bit higher. So see if we can extend it slightly up in the air. Reaching up and across. Great stuff. For five, four, three, two, and one. Slowly just leave one weight down on the ground. Then for our final movement now, we're just going to use one weight. And for that, we're going to lift up one leg at a time. We're going to pass the weight underneath, place the foot back down on the ground. Again, lift up, pass under the side, take it from the inside. So we're passing from the outside and we're taking from the inside. Just lifting those legs up one at a time, alternating as always between both. Lifting it up as high as you can. And then when you have the space created underneath, you can pass it through. You can pass it from the right hand to the left hand. Great stuff. And just two more now, so last time across. And final one. And we'll finish with that. Well done, folks. Okay, so you can take your weights now. You can place them safely to one side. If you need to grab a drink of water now, please do so. You can just leave the water back in a safe position. And then we're just going to finish off with our stretch. Okay, so a nice stretch, mainly for the upper body this morning. Okay, because most of the movements were around the arms, the chest and the back. Shoulders as well. So just starting off nice and easy. We're going to take our left hand, place it over our right shoulder. Lifting the elbow up. And we're going to gently nudge that elbow back with the opposite hand.
So gently just pushing the elbow back towards you. And just hold the stretch there for 3, 2, and 1. Relax the arms out. Take the right hand, again just placing it over the left shoulder. Lifting the elbow up, we gently nudge that elbow back. And hold the stretch there once more. Then just relax both hands down to the side. We're going to reach out in front, grabbing one hand with the other. Stretching out in front as far as we can. And then just bringing both our hands away, grabbing the back of the chair. Okay? So if you can, just reaching out behind, grabbing the sides of the back of the chair. If you can't manage to do that, that's okay. You can just reach behind as far as you can. So sticking the chest out and lifting the chin up and looking straight ahead. And just relaxing it out. Remaining on the chair, we're going to hold one hand out in front now and just going to, we're going to grab the fingertips, straightening out the arm, gently just pull the fingertips back towards you. So just holding there. Then relax the hands again, shake them out to the side, grab the opposite set of fingertips, straightening the arm, gently just pull them back towards you. Just holding the stretch there for 3, 2, and 1. And then just placing both hands as we did at the beginning on the front legs of the chair. We're just going to reach down to the side. Except this time we're just going to hold that stretch. So we're not going to come back up too quickly. Back to centre. Down to the opposite side. So down to the left hand side now for me. Reaching down once again, hold that stretch there. Back up the centre once more. Great stuff. And our just our last foot now, we're just going to take a step out to the side. Okay, so we're just going to reach that foot out, place both hands on the opposite knee, and we just gently lean forward. Okay, so a nice straight leg here, this knee is bent. Just reaching out to the side. Hold it there, come back up to centre, step out to the side now with the opposite foot, again, reaching out as far as you can, hands just before or above the bent knee and lean down to that side, lean slightly forward, and just hold the stretch there, for 3, 2, and 1, and back up once again. And then when you're ready, I'll just ask you now just to shuffle back in your seat. So just sit towards the back of the seat. There's going to be no space now between you and the back of the chair. So nice and tight up against the back of the chair. We're going to place our hands just on top of our thighs, as we did at the beginning. Palms facing up towards the ceiling. And we're going to close down the eyes. We're just going to relax just for a few moments, so just breathe as you normally would. And then we're just going to finish off this morning with 3 rounds of box breathing. So we're going to begin on my count by breathing in for 4 seconds. So 1, 2, 3. We're going to hold our breath for 1, 2, 3, and 4. We're going to exhale for 1, 2, 3, and 4. And hold once more for 1, 2, 3, and 4. We're going to inhale for 1, 2, 3, and 4. Holding the breath again for 1, 2, 3, and 4. Blowing out for 1, 2, 3.
holding the breath again for 1, 2, 3, and 4. Final round now, breathing in. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Holding the breath for 1, 2, 3, and 4. Exhale for 1, 2, 3, and 4. And final hold of the breath for 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then you can just begin to breathe as you normally would. Keep the eyes closed if you wish, just relax for a few moments again. Take a bit of time for yourself. And then when you're ready, you can slowly just begin to open the eyes and let the daylight back out. I'm happy to say I have a bit of sunshine coming in through the window here. It wasn't there when I closed my eyes, but the sun's come out since. Okay, you can just relax the hands down by the side. As always, take your time. Put your hands together, give yourselves a clap, folks, and well done. Great session this morning. I hope you were able now to use the weights, but again, if you weren't, that's no worry at all. You can just use your hands for the movements, and you can add the weights in at a later time then, if you wish. So thanks to Phyllis. Phyllis, you're a wee bit late, but no harm. You can always, you know yourself, Phyllis, you can always go back on it. And to Jerry as well. Thanks very much, Jerry. I'm sure you're a happy man after the big one on Saturday. Needless to say. So that's me for this morning, folks. I'm going to be back here on Wednesday for our standing session. And for that, just to give you a heads up, you're going to need a step of some sort. Okay? So it might be the step maybe at the front door or the back door. It could be a step maybe inside the house. Maybe a little step around the fireplace. Or even indeed if you have stairs in the house, all you'll need just is the bottom step on the stairs. So I hope you can join me for that on Wednesday. And I look forward to seeing you all then. And until then, keep moving, keep safe, and keep well. Thank you.